So merry shitty ass goddamn pandemic Christmas. I mean, look, I'm a married, childless introvert that works from home, hates gatherings, and lives 90 miles from the nearest decent restaurant. The pandemic has been easier on me than most people, or at least most people who bother to be socially responsible through it at all. But even for a cynical misanthrope like myself, missing the holidays is rough. I mean, I talk a lot of shit about Christmas because it's stupid to devote 3 months to one fucking holiday. The music's annoying. The Salvation Army is a borderline hate group, and I suck at coming up with good presents for people. And that's all exacerbated by the fact that Christians are constantly trying to make the holiday secular enough to shut down the entire country over, but religious enough for Jesus to still be the reason for the season. And all that have your fruitcake and eat it too bullshit makes my job harder every year. But all that being said, I still fucking love Christmas. Yeah, I've admitted that on the show before. I love hanging lights, and I love wrapping presents. I love tearing up at sappy Christmas commercials. Sure, and I still get all of that this year, but that shit's the icing. And getting together with the family is the cake, and eating spoonfuls of icing is depressing no matter how good it tastes. And now, obviously, this isn't the same for everybody. You know, we all have different families. I know some of our Australian and Kiwi listeners are going to be carrying on with their weird summer Christmas like more or less normal this year. I know a lot of you with big families all under one roof are going to be like, you know, having a relatively normal Christmas as well. But for people like me, people whose families are spread out all over the country and who live alone or just with their partner, this is going to be a hollow fucking Christmas. All the worse coming on the heels of that hollow Thanksgiving we just didn't have. Of course, there's a valuable lesson in the middle of it that I'm going to try to hold on to, because ever since we started doing this show, I've gotten used to these emails that come around this time of year from newly minted atheists or people who have been atheists for a while that broke away from their family's faith. And very often that meant like severing all the ties with their family and some of, if not all of their friends. And I get these heart-wrenching emails from people about how they spent Thanksgiving binging on our archives, you know, or something like that, so that they wouldn't feel as alone over the holidays. And as much as I've always tried to sympathize with those people, this is the closest I've ever come to feeling that shit for myself. I mean, don't get me wrong. I don't want to oversell the woe-is-me shit here, right? My family wants to see me. I can call them on the phone or hop on a Zoom call with them, and I probably will. They sent me cards. We exchanged gifts through the mail. We're all looking forward to getting together next year and making up for this fucked up shit year. In that sense, this is the difference between being homeless and camping. And even this minuscule taste of what it's like for those people is enough to fucking wreck me. It's always been so weird to me that religion harps on family togetherness as one of its main merits. Right, they're fond of saying the family that prays together stays together, but it's always the religious people saying that. So, you know, it sounds a lot like when the terrorists tell the hostages that if nobody tries to escape, nobody's going to get shot. It's only true because religious people will disown their kids if they stop praying. That's not a benefit. That's a threat. And yet religions, probably the number one cause of broken families in the country and indeed the world, can't say enough about how great they are at bringing families together. I mean, hell, even where they don't lead to outright shunning, religious disagreements have a unique place in our social interactions for their ability to cultivate long-term animosity. I mean, you know, politics can do the same thing, I guess, but that's a real thing with consequences. Religious arguments are like a heated debate about energy policy and Shannara, and yet they engender such contempt and idiocy that people will voluntarily shun themselves rather than risk part 27 of the "but then how come I can't rape your wife" argument that your cousin's going to bring to this year's reunion. I mean, if there's a silver lining around anything in 2020, it's probably because it's kicking off some kind of previously unknown form of deadly radiation. But I intend to spend a lot of my time on Christmas, on that lonely, echoey Christmas, thinking about all the people who have to suffer through this shit every year. And I hope it stays with me. I hope it reminds me in 2021 and in all of the Christmases to come how important it is that we offer community to people who have been robbed of theirs and how important it is that we invite them into our families. So anyway, on that like weird twisted attempt at getting a Christmas message out of this shit, merry goddamn fucking bullshit ass pandemic Christmas and happy good riddance to this shithole year day.